because it's bragging rights. Like, the rivalries matter.
And that pass is intercepted. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
Really early in this game, you're seeing the ball hop.
For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football. And the Golden Gophers will boot it away to start the game. Fielded in the end zone, it's Morgan. Not nearly as much as he'd hoped when he brought it out of the end zone. He'll be stopped in the 15. The Wolverines return team didn't help matters out much with that one. These rivalry games can really get the blood pumping, and we'll see who can manage their emotions best early.
Everyone's been waiting for this game, right? You know, both of these teams have had this game circled all the way back to the beginning of the offseason, so you've got to be able to play under control.
With passion, with energy, with hatred, because it's a rivalry game, but keep your emotions in check and making sure I'm controlling what I can control.
Feeling some heat. He makes a catch. And the tackle is made, but not before that completion gets them 30-plus.
And how about that start for the offense in this game? You could not ask for a better play. They come out firing, going down the field. They get a huge completion. What a way to begin this football contest.
Looking to throw, it's Orji. Unloads to the wideout. Excellent coverage and good use of the hands to knock it away. We anticipate this one being much tighter than the last time these two met when it was a blowout, David.
And here's the thing. You got an opportunity right now. You got the football early in this game to show you. This is going to be more of the same, Palmer.
Well, we talked to both coaching staffs and players, and they're all very aware of what happened the last time these two teams played. So expect everybody's A game today. Reese, you're right. We expect this one to be a lot tighter.
Ball still at the 45 after the incompletion. They'll snap it second and 10. And I don't think they got it snapped before the play clock ran out. So frustrating to see an offense lose track of the play clock and pick up a penalty like that. Now on second down. He's looking to throw. Fires to the tight end. They make the stop, but not before he takes a chunk out of what they need to move the sticks.
I'll say this, man. In college football, you see a lot of bad tackling. You didn't see it right there. That was an awesome job. First off, being there at the point of attack. Once the tight end made the catch, there was no doubt he was going down. Great job, form tackle.
And they can't make the connection on third down.
Well, they try to throw for it there on third down on the opening drive of the game. They don't get it, but let's punt the ball away. Let's trust our defense. And, guys, let's also trust this home field advantage and the crowd to get loud and make it real difficult on our opponent.
The offense stays on the field. Opening drive still in their own territory. They'll go for it on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. And that pass intercepted. Not a lot on the return, but they can live with that as they've got it at the 49.
Well, we knew coming into this one, this was an offense that wanted to come out, sling it around, but the timing is going to have to be a whole lot better. This defense has athletes who can close on the ball and make plays, and you saw it right there in that interception to open this game.
This crowd trying to make life miserable for this offense. The run from the shotgun. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. So you get stuffed on first down. You had an idea of what you wanted to do on second, but I'm guessing it's back to the drawing board now.
You got to figure out who you are and what you are. What's your next best play? Or what is the defense going to do? They've been aggressive? Okay, well, if they've been aggressive, to throw that deep ball. If they've been sitting back, I might sneak a draw in.
Nice defensive play to get a hand in there and knock it away. The biggest lie college football coaches tell is nameless, faceless opponent. David, game like this, you know their name and you know their face.
You know them well, and it does mean just a little bit more because it's bragging rights. Like, the rivalries matter.
And that pass is intercepted. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
Really early in this game, you're seeing the ball hawks on both sides of the ball. Interception on the first drive of the game, and now they come out, and this defense gets a pick in return. There are a lot of dudes in the back end with speed, with the ability to close. What a phenomenal play by that young man just now to get the ball back to his offense.
Michigan ready to get that offense rolling again. After that last pick, David, they really need to take care of the ball this time.
No doubt. And Palmer, I want to know what Spurrier said to you on the sideline after a pick.
Do that again and you'll be right here beside me for the rest of the game. You got to go out. You got to call your plays. And I hope this coaching staff isn't going to be afraid to throw at this drive.
Not a whole lot of progress made there on the short run.
Now, that's what you're trying to do as a defense. Limit those damages when they run the football. Get them on the ground, short gains to set your defense for positive situations down the road.
Trying to turn the corner on the right. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
Looking to throw, it's Orgy. And a missed opportunity on third down as the defense knocks it free, and fourth down is coming up. And the Wolverines decide to punt it away. The punter going to get his first work of the afternoon. Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. And the coverage team down there to touch the ball. No return on this play. Minnesota has it back, and the Gopher offense is headed onto the field. Boy, they hope this next drive is more productive after throwing a pick last time, Jesse.
Yeah, and the coaches did a good job on the sideline there, just talking to the young quarterback and making sure he's able to turn the page, calm him down, to go out and refocus this drive.
Yeah, and some people do that better than others, but you got to show some trust in him, maybe get the ground game going, help around him a little bit with this system.
And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down.
Well, this defense knew coming in they were going to see some RPO and they were going to see some quick game, and nice job there taking the throw away from the quarterback.
And after the incompletion on first down, this offense looking at second down. Out of the gun, the running back has it. Gets away from one, finds room.
Defense is going to have their hands full trying to stop this guy. They better rally to the football and get multiple hats because he is not easy to bring down.
The Golden Gophers getting set on first and 10. Wide out in motion. Right back to the well. Plows through the defense.
Well, it's plays like that that'll help this offense stay in rhythm all game long. If you can have that kind of success on first down running the football, it just opens up your entire playbook moving forward.
Back to throw, it's Brosmer. Firing to the right, complete. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage before he was stopped, but using the running back in the short passing game gives him a first down.
I like the running back there on the route and the patience he showed, really setting it up. He got to the defender, was able to put his foot in the ground, get some separation, catch it, and turn upfield for a first.
To the air on first down. Missed his receiver there. It's incomplete. They'll line up for a second down play. He's looking to throw. Those two not on the same page. It's incomplete. This drive was clicking along, but after a couple of misfires, threatening to stall out on 3rd and 10. The aerial assault continues. Can't make the connection on 3rd down thanks to that tough, hard-nosed pass defense, and now it's 4th down. They'll send out the kicker to try to salvage this drive. It's good. Hold on just a second. There's a flag on the field. Let's see what's up with that.
Roughing the kicker. Defense.
Can't make contact with the kicker like that. A costly special teams penalty. You've got to know your path in front of the kicker. Offense comes back on the field. The defense in a most benevolent move, giving the offense a new set of downs. The give is to Taylor. And he's loose, and he'll take it to the house. Touchdown, Minnesota! Follow the blockers. The offensive line will take you to the hallelujah land.
And I tell you what, most of the time, Reese, it requires a little bit of skill to find that hole and, you know, slither through a little crack. That was not a crack. That was wide open. Didn't take a lot of vision because the blocking was outstanding.
He'll start the return inside his 5. Slips through the line. This guy is so dangerous. The excellent vision to find the lane and get it out and set up the offense with good field position. 3 tight ends in the formation on 1st and 10. Running back searching for a hole. We'll give him a couple on that one. 2nd and 8 coming up.
You know, runs like this oftentimes are like a boxer in a boxing match. Obviously, it's not a knockout punch, but these are body blows. As the game goes on, these small gains are going to turn into longer runs.
After picking up a couple, it's 2nd and 8. Here's the handoff. Pretty good effort on that one to work his way up to the 42.
And as an offensive coordinator, you don't need the perfect play with this guy as your running back. He's going to make the play perfect for you because he makes everybody miss. Spin moves, hurdles, stiff arms, speed, whatever it takes to move the sticks and score touchdowns.
On 3rd and short, just trying to get enough for the 1st down. They get him on the ground, but it's a 1st down. Line gets set, 1st down. That's going to do it for the quarter, and Minnesota has the lead here. And we've come to the end of the first as we take a moment to check out the stats so far. Of time left, and we're ready to get back to it and open the 2nd period. They'll break the seal on this quarter here on 1st down. They'll give it to the back. At the 40, there he goes! And they got the defense on that one, and they get it to the 29-yard line.
Nice job getting outside, right? Those running backs, they get on those tracks, they run outside. Now they're in the open field. It's so tough. Those safeties are flying down, try to get an angle, but you could tell the speed sets them up, makes the big play out to the left.
The Wolverines have this offense rolling. Power football with the run. And a nice run there before the defense finally makes the stop.
Yeah, this coaching staff, they're getting this offensive line lathered up and into a rhythm. Now they're letting them drive off the ball on 1st down on these running plays, and they're getting chunks of yardage.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on 1st down. It's 2nd and 3. give to the running back. And he's brought to the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down.
All right, defense, that's what we can't do. We can't give up this many chunk yards on the ground. Got to commit more guys to the line of scrimmage. Got to get those running backs on the ground. That's way too easy.
Finally, this offense starting to show a little juice. They've got a first and 10. The give to the back. And he finds some solid space, makes a nice game before the defense is able to stop him.
Keep pounding away at this defense and make them play the run. If you can get this many a chunk, they're going to have to commit more guys to the box, more guys to the run, then you open it up for the passing game.
Going to work on second down in the red zone is still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. He'll try it again. He steps and powers and works his way. They finally get him down at the 2.
You know, you start day one of training camp running your base runs. You need a few yards, you run these plays. You need a first down, you run these plays. You rep them over and over and over again. They're not sexy, they're not pretty, but in the end, they're effective, and they get you that new set of downs when you need them.
Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, Wolverines.
Down in tight to the goal line, you saw some good movement up front by the offensive line, getting a push and giving that running back a chance.
PAT unit on the field. Hit that one with some aggression for the point after. They put together a 65-yard drive for the score and finished the deal with the short touchdown run from the 2. All tied up and just about set to kick it away. Out of the end zone. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Minnesota offense is headed back onto the field. Now they need to put something together to answer that last score.
There's a lot of pressure, too, on this offense to have to execute at a high level. They've got to score points, David, but they can't go too fast because their defense right now is tied.
And I think that's the difficulty being a play caller. Like, I have to balance all of those things. My defense is a little bit tired. I can't get on the field, but I got to be aggressive because this is a back-and-forth type game, so a lot to process and think about.
Counter run plays really tricky for defenses to stop because it forces you to play with great eye discipline. Everything in pre-snap is telling you the ball's going to the strong side, but now they run it back weak and they're pulling offensive linemen. This defense better be ready because this won't be the last time today they see the counter run.
Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry.
And how about the timing of the linebacker on the blitz to get in the backfield and get the tackle for loss?
Is there anything better for a linebacker than to run on a blitz and nobody's home except the back?
Such a great feeling when the Moses parts the Red Sea and the hole opens up and you go fill it.
Decibels rising as the crowd gets behind this defense on third down. To the air, it's Brosmer trying to get to it. He's got him wide open, and he's brought down after a huge completion. The clock is not their friend. Got to get everybody to the line quickly. They'll throw it on first down. Fires into traffic, picked off. And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception. He looked as if he thought he had it all the way, and this junior makes a play.
This is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. 2 interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision making.
Guys, here come those maize and blue winged helmets on offense. How big is this drive? Scored a touchdown the last time they had it. Defense gets a stop, and now it's up to them in a tie game.
All right, so if you're the offensive coordinator here, let's dial it in. Who are your best matchups and best playmakers to take advantage of this golden opportunity.
Yeah, and I'm interested to see this defense, too. Like, the momentum is clearly not in your favor. How do you get it back? How do you make a big play? Do you be more aggressive here to try to get the football back to your offense?
Stop just inside the 30 at the 29. It's a 10-yard pickup and a first down.
And that is just an attitude run, running it right up the middle, right into the teeth of that defense.
Just inside the 30 at the 29, it's first and 10. They'll try the run. You'll take 4 yards on first down every time, second and 6.
You know, it's so important for offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
Using his legs, it's Edwards. And they drag him down, but not before he picks up the first down.
Man, that was a good run, but it was almost even better. Great job by the offense. Keep the running game going. You get big chunks like this. Not only was that a big chunk, it also looked like it could have gone for more.
And the Wolverines will snap it on first and 10. They'll leave it with him. And that's a very productive first down play and bringing up second and 3.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Leaves it with the running back. He'll be brought down, and that's the final play of the half. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with the halftime update.
Gentlemen, seldom do the rational turn irrational the way they do when these two teams and fan bases get together with a little brown jug on the line. And if you thought that was a quick first half, you'd be right on the money. An offensive showcase, yes, but it's been those dynamic running backs who have set the pace. I'm curious to find out if this ground-and-pound approach is going to continue into the second half, or if one of those defenses will actually show some pride.
The Wolverines will kick it away first, and we'll start the second half. And he'll just take a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Minnesota has it back, and the Gopher offense is headed onto the field. First drive of the second half, always fun to watch. You see what type of tweaks were made at the half, especially when you're locked up in a ball game like this one.
Yeah, and it's been a...
The freshman able to get home with the sack.
Oftentimes with play action, you're asking the quarterback to hold on to the ball a bit longer, and you're asking this offensive line to hold up and pass pro a bit longer. Against this athletic front seven on defense, it's going to be tough.
We'll see if they can dig one up. It goes forward this time on second down from the 18. Leaves it with the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, good call by the defense there. They dialed up blitz into that running play, and the linebacker able to make the stop.
Better find the earplugs. Here comes the noise, backing this defense on third down. How about this backer in pass coverage and bringing the big hit stick with him, too? And the Golden Gophers will send out the punt unit. Three and out, they got stuck in reverse. They hope the punt can bail them out. Makes a move. Return's going to get it up around midfield. He'll be down at the 49-yard line. And here comes the Michigan offense back on the field. The sledding has been tough. Scores have been at a premium, Jesse, and every possession seems like it could switch the momentum of the game.
Yeah, Reese, for this offense, just feels like they just haven't been as physical. And for this offensive coordinator, David, he's having to go deep into the playbook just to try to generate a first down.
Well, and the good thing is there's not a ton of game pressure because the other side's not scoring either. But if you can find that one thing, then get that one positive play, and then maybe you get those juices going and something can start to build.
They're down to the 32-yard line on first and 10. Dropping back, it's Orji. Fires to the big fella. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down. We talk a lot about Michigan building its offense around the running game, but they've always had an effective quarterback who can make plays down the field.
And I think some people hear effective, Reese, and take that as an insult, right? Like, I don't want to hear about my quarterback being effective. I want him to be explosive. I want him to be dynamic. But Michigan doesn't really have those guys most of the time at that quarterback spot. But when they find those good ones, they have great seasons.
They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. That linebacker was a heat-seeking missile, and the heat that he sought was the ball carrier.
Yeah, great job, great feel. Linebackers are making all the calls in the defense and understanding when I need to come through that gap and come through with bad intentions. Those guys are usually 245 pounds of heat-seeking missile.
Got some room, headed to the goal line. Touchdown, Michigan! And with that, they've got the lead here in the second half.
And the offense continues to run the football. The second rushing touchdown from the running back. The offensive line paving holes continue to feed this man the ball.
He'll try to tack on one more. And the PAT gives him a 14-7 lead. Quick work on that scoring drive, just four plays. And it was capped with an explosive 22-yard run. And he's coming out of the end zone. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Minnesota offense is headed back onto the field. Last time, David, it was 1-2-3 kick.
That last drive, that three and out, sometimes that puts your defense in a bad spot, and you got to get a drive together here so you don't wear the defense out.
I just think, David, too predictable that last drive. They got to do something here to get this defense on the field.
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. It's a draw. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry.
Man, a lot of times when you blitz that linebacker, it's about timing. You don't show your hand, and he gets up to the line of scrimmage, gets right through the line, makes the tackle for a loss.
And as soon as the running back gets the football, he's got a face full of linebacker.
Not much you can do there. Like, you got to have a little better block. You got to identify that blitz a little bit faster by the offensive line.
Oh, they really could have used that catch there. Physical pass defense. It brings up a fourth down. The Golden Gophers will line up to punt it away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. He'll bring it back. It's Morgan. Really good job by the coverage team to make the stop, and that's where they'll put it in play. Michigan ready to get that offense rolling again. That last drive, really productive. David wound up with a touchdown. They'll try to do it again.
Yeah, so I don't expect this offense to change too much, Reese. They had a great drive. They got the touchdown. Everything working. I would expect them to keep pushing this ball downhill.
And just imagine if they could put another touchdown on the board right here. They could capture so much momentum in this game with back-to-back TDs.
When you're a defense, it is stop the run first. That is your first responsibility. It makes the whole game easy. And right now, they got it going on the ground. The defense is going to have to change something up. These little tiny dink and dunk, dink and dunk. You keep doing this, they'll go all the way down the field on us. You might want to get a little bit more aggressive.
After the last run, would you just give it to him again on third down? To the ground to try to pick up the first. They tried to go smash mouth on third and short, and it did not work against this defense.
Nice play by the defense, but now is a time they've got to be more consistent. They allowed this running back to go off in that first half, and moving forward now, they've got to try and take this running back away.
Trying to show their strength with the run on fourth down. They stop him short of the marker, and they'll turn it over on downs. Minnesota has it back, and the Gopher offense is headed onto the field, looking for a productive play on first down. The give to the back. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
I love this linebacker because he's able to dissect what's happening in front of him, and he reacts downhill, uses his speed to get to the line of scrimmage and create the negative play.
They'll go right back to the run. And he slid through that attempt, and he's got room. How about the patience from this sophomore to hunt that green grass?
When the running back gets going and gets ahead of steam like that, so hard to get to the ground. That's why you blitz. That's why you bring pressure. That's why you bring more guys in the box so you can get him before he gets going. But once he got going, you could tell it was hard to get a hand on, hard to get him to the ground.
Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. Scanning the field, it's Brosmer. Working the middle, it's complete. A 6-yard pickup that leaves them with third and four.
I like the decision by the quarterback here. Just get the ball out of your hands, get it to your playmaker. A lot of times he'll dance and make even bigger plays than he did here, but it was still a positive game.
In the gun, looking to throw on third down. Grabs it in the middle. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down. And the Golden Gophers are rolling down the field. If you like old school running games, this has been the game for you and a couple of guys who starred through the first three periods. One more period to go to see who can make the winning plays and come home with the victory. To open the quarter with this first down play. They want to just keep throwing it. And it's picked off for the third time today. Bringing it back. The 20. The 10. Not only a great play, but tremendous discipline by this sophomore to make the pick.
Man, what a play. Now you're setting your offense up for great position, but you want to make big plays as a defense. Not only make big plays, return it a long way down the field. You wanted a touchdown, obviously, but you set your offense up in great scoring position.
And this defense has to step forward. Not only do they have to get a stop, they've got to do it quickly to keep that time from running down. A first down run on the doorstep. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, Wolverines. Michigan has dominated this rivalry over the years, and they will go so close to securing the jug again.
You look at Michigan on paper, and they have an advantage all over the place against Minnesota. It was a question of whether they could just stay out of their own way. If they eliminated the mistakes, we knew this was going to be a tall order for Minnesota, and Michigan just looks dominant, David.
Yeah, it stinks, but it is the facts. The facts are you're less talented at Minnesota, man. You've got to play really, really well, especially in these rivalry games, and hope to catch Michigan on a bad day. But that little brown jug is inching towards Michigan's sideline now.
And he tacked on the extra point. About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. Fielded in the end zone. It's Taylor. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. The Minnesota offense is headed back onto the field. Mistakes are going to happen, as they did on that last drive. Now, how will they respond, Jesse?
And this is the kind of guy who's going to take full accountability. That was my bad. That's on me. I'm about to lead this offense now down the field to score some points.
Dang, Palmer. I wish I would have played with you. I didn't play with many quarterbacks that are just like, yeah, my bad. Hey, guys, I got this. Sorry about that. If you want, you should have ran a better route.
I think if you're the head coach at this point, you're telling your offense, it doesn't matter what's happened up at this point. Obviously, things haven't gone our way, but we have a chance to execute in a two-minute situation and give ourselves a chance to win. Let's go do it one play at a time.
Finds his big tight end. Excellent job working through the air there, finding a hole in that defense and picking up a first down.
Well, down two possessions. Good news is you get the completion. Bad news, though, did not get out of bounds. You know right now, saving the clock, that is at a premium for this offense.
Going up top on first down. And the freshman will chalk up a sack.
It's been a little bit of a seesaw here the last two plays. Offense gets a chunk play, and then the defense gets a sack. Great job by the defense there, turning the page, coming up with the big one.
Not a lot of productivity on that last play. They'll try it again on second and long from the 23. They try to pop a run on the draw. At the 35, he's loose. And he was loose and not stopped until he gets to the 47-yard line. The Golden Gophers come to the line in the hurry up.
Man, this guy's a playmaker, and he does not need a lot of space. Really nice job that time letting the pass rush get upfield. So when he got the football, there was just green grass out ahead of him, and he made the defense pay.
And when I got a guy like that, man, I just got to find ways to get him past the D-line, right? And then the draw play is a good way to do it. Let them run themselves up the field. Then you can see he's got some serious speed. A lot of speed in space is always a good recipe for offense.
Dropping back, it's Grosmer. They'll throw it to the back on the screen. And the catch was one thing, and the run even better. A big pickup on that one. And the Golden Gophers have it with a first and 10.
Hey, man, sometimes you get the perfect play call at the perfect time. That time, the defense blitzing, offensive line allowed everybody to run upfield, and they slip in the running back screen, and behind it, there was nobody there to make a tackle, and this offense generates a massive play.
Wants to go up top. He's got it in the end zone! Touchdown, Golden Gophers! Well, we wondered exactly where the momentum was, and it looks as if Uncle Mo might have switched sidelines and switched families.
And momentum is such a big thing. It's such a real part of college football, isn't it? And you can just feel that right now. It just felt a few minutes ago like this game was over, and all of a sudden, this team, they're believing in themselves. They've got some win. They've got some hope. Their defense now needs to get the football back to keep that momentum going.
On the move from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Guys, here come those maize and blue winged helmets on offense. The defense will have to key on the run and try to get this ball back. The give, and tick, 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 tick. They shut it down quickly, but he gets two out to the 18.
Well, at this point of the game, with the lead in the fourth quarter, deep in their own end, they're going to want to run the football, no doubt. The defense knows that, and they're going to be trying to rip it out, seeing if they can get a takeaway to set up their offense in great field position. So ball security right here has got to be big.
Just gets it to the 28, pickup of one.
And ball security at this point is at a premium for this offense. You're backed up in your own end. You've got the lead, so you want to be able to run the football and stay on the field, bleed the clock. But you know the defense is going to be ripping away at it, right? They're going to be trying to get hacks to the football and forcing a fumble. So whoever's got the ball has got to have two hands on it this drive.
And the defense is swarming to keep him from getting to the first down. We've reached a two-minute warning in this offense, trying to milk this clock and keep time on their side. They have the lead in a one-possession game, but they're thinking deliver the knockout blow, but this carries big-time risk on fourth down. Try to get it on the ground. He's not going to get there. Stopped short on fourth down.
And the offense goes for the knockout punch. They wanted to get the first down, run out this clock, take the dub. Now their defense is going to have to come out and step up big for them and make sure they don't give up any points.
Gets it out fast. They stop him just short of the first down, but it will be second and inches coming up. The offense gets a quick timeout at this point. Every second is precious. The noise level is relentless here on second down. They'll run it in the red zone. It's Taylor. The Golden Gophers get enough for the first down.
This is an offense that really sees their identity as being able to run the football. Nice job there picking up the first down.
Huge moment coming here as they try to punch it in and quiet this crazy, raucous crowd. Might as well run him until they stop him. He's got it again.
That's just a really nice job by the running back, making the first guy miss and going to get positive yards. This guy's got some wiggle, you saw it on the play.
Going to work in the red zone. They can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. He's got it. Takes it to the house. Touchdown, Minnesota.
Great job with the score. And listen, right here at this point in the game, there's still going to be time left. My defense is going to have to make a stand regardless. I'm going to kick the extra point because the field goal still beats me if I go for a two-point conversion.
Coming down the stretch in the fourth, and we are all tied up, about set to kick it away. And he takes this from inside the five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. And here comes the Michigan offense back on the field. A pretty good bit of ground to cover here, Jesse, but they've got some time to work with.
They do. So tempo is going to be important. You got to go fast. You just got to make good decisions at the quarterback position.
And those good decisions are throwing the ball beyond the sticks, using the sidelines to get out of bounds, try to maximize this time and get in a position to win.
Timeout on the field, and we've got a dandy all tied up late in the fourth. This offense has a second down play. Couldn't connect on first down, now back to the air. Wide open downfield. And it is a chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end. Timeout called by the offense, and now they just have one remaining in the half. Line gets set, first down. Looking to move it through the air. Finds his tight end. They stop him just a link or two short of the first, and man, what they can do on second down here. Quick timeout from the offense to save precious seconds. Picked up some yardage with that completion. Now second down. They're going to throw it again. And that pass will be jarred loose on second down. That brings up third down.
Yeah, and that's fine. Listen, it's go time, right? Now it's coming up on third down. You probably got two downs anyways. It's the fourth quarter. It's time for this QB to take charge.
They can really use a few yards here on third down because from here, it would be a 61-yard attempt. They'll try to get outside. Crosses the 30, he's got away. Touchdown, Michigan! And they've got the lead in the final minute.
And man, this game has been awesome. Some back and forth. Now you take the lead late. Nice job by the offense. And now you just need your defense to come through for you. One more time, one stop, less than a minute remaining. Go out there, finish this thing off.
And the big fellas are on the field as they try to power it in for two. Trying to surge it in. He stopped short on the two-point conversion attempt. They went right back to the well with a man who scored the touchdown, but he couldn't get it in for the two. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Minnesota has it back, and the Gopher offense is headed onto the field. These are the games. These are the moments. This is the opportunity for the finish that people remember in rivalries like this one.
And those highlights that are shown for years and years to come. These big-time moments, Palmer, coming down to the wire, who steps up and makes the big time?
And this is why you lift the weights in the offseason. This is why you do all the gassers and all the sprints. For moments like this, game on the line and one of the biggest games of the year.
From his end zone, he'll have to get rid of it. Caught in the backfield, it's Taylor. And he'll step across the sidelines after making a good gain on that one.
Guys out of the backfield now, it's not just run the ball downhill anymore. You got to be versatile. I got to be able to trust you in the pass game, and I got to be able to throw you the football, and you can do that right there. I know you're going to catch it, and I can depend on you.
A deep throw as the clock winds down, and he bats it away. It falls incomplete.
And it's now or never. It's do or die for this offense. Fourth down, late in the game, trailing. They absolutely have to connect and move the chains right here. This thing's over.
Fourth down, gotta have it here. He's going up top here late in the game. And it is another interception. Just a terrible struggle for this quarterback. He is finally out of bounds, but he was smelling that end zone on that return.
And that is a backbreaker. It's fourth down, though. Listen, you gotta throw the football. You gotta try to make a play. But the defense came up big in a big moment.
Michigan ready to get that offense rolling again. And now, Jesse, the art here is to find the balance between milking the clock and trying to get another score.
I think if you're the coaching staff, too, you like to see your team play its best in the fourth quarter, right? Defense just did their job, so offense now.
And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Wolverines.
That is exactly what you want your offense to do. You want it to eat clock, but if you score, go up by two possessions, nail, beat, coffin. Great execution by this offense to put this game away.
Now the two-point conversion attempt is coming.
White 53! White 53!
Trying to pound their way in. He's going to be stopped short of the goal line. The two-point attempt is no good as they are unable to extend the lead. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And they thought about a return, then thought better of it. They'll bring it out to the 25. The Minnesota offense is headed back onto the field. It's a long shot, I know, but you have to keep fighting till the bitter end, Jesse.
They call it a long shot for a reason, because they've still technically got a shot.
And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17. The offense will use a timeout clock to stop with 22 seconds left. What can they pull out of the playbook here on second and long from the 17? Looking for a man, it's Brosmer. Not much of a chance there. He just had to get rid of it to avoid the sack.
And how loud is it in this building? This is crazy. These fans are going absolutely nuts. And I used to love when the fans got involved and I'm on defense, because it messes with the snap count, it messes with the communication, and it can really rattle an offense.
Didn't have anything working and just had to throw it away on third down.
After that incompletion, fourth and long now on your own side of the field, you're trailing in the fourth quarter. What's your go-to play call here in the passing game? Where is the...
And they get to him and sack the quarterback, and they'll stop the drive on down. Linebacker shuffling around, trying to keep the quarterback from getting a read. They'll see if they can find some running room on the right here. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. There's a long and storied history of great games between these two rivals, and this chapter adds another to that legacy.
Really impressed by the poise by the winning team as well here. They weren't overhyped in this game. They came out, they looked prepared, they were calm, definitely confident. David, they were able to go out and execute well enough to get this win.
And it's hard in these rivalry games with all the emotions running so deep. Like, you sometimes get overzealous. Sometimes you get too many penalties. It's hard to rein in your emotions, but they did. They kept it in check, and now bragging rights for a whole year.
That's going to do it for us from here. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.